Well, I've been back for a couple of weeks. I've done a fair bit of restoring on a lot of these relics from the gold fields. I'll get them, and most of them are clogged up with rust. And I'll soak them in water for a few days, try and get as much as a caked on dirt, and sometimes it can be just as hard as concrete, and get it off. Then I'll soak it again, and when I do pull it out, I'll dry it and put it in a container of old oil I've got. And hopefully enough, when I pull them out and drain them, they won't suffer any more decay. This one here, I've started on this one already. It was caked with rust and probably 130, 140 years of mud, dirt and rubbish in it. And when they come out after I've restored them to the best of my ability, they're like that. And I hope I'm doing a good job so I can pass them on to future generations. Now, just some of the finds, I want to go through a few of them. This is the F branding iron I recovered, and that was a very, very good find, that. I found this one as well, and tell you what, when the coil went over it, it just nearly blew my head off. But because it was a working gold field, you know, taking quartz to the stampers, I thought maybe it could be actually the hinge off the side of a wagon carting some of the rock to the stampers. I don't know, but that's what I hope anyway. Then you've got this here. Now, this is very self-explanatory for those who've ever been out in the bush. You know, you've got this hanging from the pole going across the old campfire, so with your billy on or whatever. But yes, we had some good finds when Mick and my son and I were out. This is the little belt buckle Mick found. It's got the stumps and the cricket ball in the middle, but unfortunately it's bent over and it's very, very fragile, so I've got to be very careful with that one. Mick also dug this. He sure as hell beat me in recovering belt buckles this time, and that's a nice find as well. This is the buckle, that purse buckle I told you I'd restore to the best of my ability. Well, that's it there. You can see it's all free now, and this just clips back on it. But yeah, it was came out better than I expected. Now, when I ran the coil over this, as you can imagine, when I dug this, it was encrusted with dirt and all that, and I thought I had a nug because it was just so heavy. But luck wasn't with me that day, but never mind. Anyway, I've got a few other finds here. I haven't got a clue what this is, but it could be a small tool. I thought maybe it might have been, you know, like fingernail cleaner or something like that, because it's got a couple of prongs there in the middle. I honestly don't know. But so I found two of them very close to each other. This one's suffered a little bit of damage. But yeah, I just wonder what they are. So yeah, it's a bit of a mystery for me. Anyway, I've got a few more finds, bullets, pistol balls, you know, imagine that hitting you, and all these other bullets. I've got a few buttons as well, did very well in the button department, and some old harness buckles as well. Mick dug this, and I believe it may be the base off a kerosene lamp, but yes, I clean that up and it'll go very well in the cabinet. This is that tap I recovered, and look, it's beautiful. It's all pure brass or bronze or whatever, but I think it's a later type one, as with the head, you know, the turning on and off. And yes, but that was a fantastic find. That was beautiful. Anyway, just moving over here, I've got three axe heads here, and you know, they'd be a pretty important object up on the gold fields. But with these here, they're like, they're iron, but they're still very, very sharp. And as you can see with this one here, you can see where they've, okay, with probably a stone, taken the blade back, and these are quite sharp. I'd still put a handle in those and be able to chop a tree down. But yeah, they're three beautiful examples. You can see also that they've used them, maybe they've tried to split logs with them, and they've used these as a wedge as well. Gave it a heart. They've all been utilised in that way. And, yeah, this one here, It's a beautiful example with that grinding of the blade. Beautiful. At the moment, I'm restoring an old trunk. This was my dad's trunk he built in the 1940s. Needed a lot of work done to it, and I'm slowly getting there. And it's a project, ongoing project at the moment. And it's going to be, well, hopefully look fantastic when I'm finished with it. Probably about a week ago, I was looking on Gumtree while the wife was shopping, which blokes tend to do, sit in their car and get on the net somewhere. And there was a couple of here in town, I thought they were selling some bottles they said they'd picked up during their travels out west. Anyway, I rang them up and they said, yep, come around. And as luck would have it, I was the first person to actually go around. So I had pick of the bottles. Now, this one here is the District Hospital Mackay, and this looks like it's been used once and just put away, never to be seen again. But I've got bottles from Townsville, Brisbane, Claremont, Central Queensland. I've got some from Serena, Mackay, all over the Queensland and the Western districts out there. I also picked up quite a few insulators, as you can see. I don't know whether it's here. This one here, I don't know whether it's a manufacturing fault or it's actually been made that way, but it's the only one like it. But anyway, look at all these poison bottles. Now this one here, okay, this is a very, very good example of a poison bottle. Now I didn't know they made crown seals in poison bottles, but as you can see, there it is. And this one here, it's marked poison and imperial quart down the bottom. But yeah, I was very, very happy to get those, because normally when I do go after bottles, someone else has had the pick of the bunch, and I've just had the dregs, but I scored very well. Now, I haven't seen one of these for probably well over 40 years, and when I saw it, I had to snap it up, and it was with the bottles. And yes, I did very well with that one. I'm going to leave it as is. There are methods you can use to get the rust out or the staining out, but I'll leave it as it is. Yeah, I can remember my grandmother putting a few of these in here, in the chook pen, so the hens would see the egg and they'd want to lay a few more. But anyway, that's how well I did when I was out with Mick out in the goldfields. I've got to add a few more cabinets in here because there's getting less and less room. But anyway, I'm looking forward to my next trip out west. All the best, I'll see you later. Well, after a fair bit of hard work and shuffling around, I've cleaned a lot of areas, added some new shelves, and basically I've got the area that I work in about 99% prepped. I've still got a little bit to go here and there, but mainly it's just on this side and what's on the shelves. I just have to take off dust and put them back as I see fit. By the way, I've added another detector to my arsenal. It's a Garrett AT Pro International. I've heard a lot about this detector and it's all been good. So I thought I'd better do what they say, you know, go out, get one, and go out in the bush and test it. But yeah, I'm looking forward to taking this little girl out to, you know, detect. Anyway, I've got some of my finds here. These are from the last trip I went away, so I filmed most of them before, but these ones have been sitting in oil baths for quite a while, and I've just cleaned them up, and they're just almost 100% like they were so many years ago. I just enjoy the ridge. You can see the ridge here where it's been sharpened to give that a blade, and quite honest with you, these have all got very, very sharp blades on them still today after all that time in the bush. But yes, I've done a fair bit of work here, and I'm looking to going out bush again very, very soon. Got to make another board for a few more plaques. I've got a few of my rabbit and dog traps put up there, and I've also done a few more little alterations to my room and my collection. But anyway, I've got to get back into it. I've got other things to do. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you later.